Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to go over Drake R&B chords. Now, once you understand how to formulate these chords, applying them is very simple because it's just a matter of knowing how to do it. So firstly, let's play the chord progression for this song. So I'll show you the two different parts of the chord progression. And we're going to get into what type of chords we use. It's very simple. It's not complicated music theory. It's just a certain type of chord you need to learn. Again, you can learn more about music theory at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. Now the chord type used here is a ninth chord. So ninth chords are very jazzy. Similar to seventh chords, they're very lush and very jazzy. Seventh chords are a little less jazzy than ninth chords. Ninth chords are, you know, specifically jazzy or more in the jazz roots. And all we're doing here to create a ninth chord is we're using chord codes, or you can build out your scale, which is all the white notes, and simply skip every other white note. So we started at D, skip the next white note E, go to F. Skip G, go to A. Skip B, go to C. Skip D, go to E. And when you have five notes, that's a ninth chord. When you have four notes, that's a seventh chord. Now, I'm generalizing, okay? There's a lot more specificity to it. But again, we cover that in the whole Music Theory Essentials course at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. The key here, though, is to use ninth chords. And you can see all I'm doing is just using a ninth chord going up the scale. So the chord goes D, F, A, C. And if you notice, all those notes are actually in the first chord. So it goes D is the root note, then F. And then we actually use F as the next root note. And then A becomes the next root note. And then C becomes the next root note for that ninth chord. Okay, so it's a pattern here. And then E becomes the next root note for the last chord. So really, if you combine all the root notes for these chords, it equals the first chord. D, F, A, C, E. So if you ever get confused, you can even break your chord down that you started with and use each of those notes as a root note for your chords and build out the ninth chord. Now, ninth chords have a specific chord code. Again, you can learn more about the chord codes. If you're confused about this, it's because you're jumping into something that you don't understand. And we cover that. We cover the basics at BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. So they're all ninth chords. This is a ninth chord. So D, F, A creates the minor chord, for example. D, F, A, C creates the minor seventh, and then D, F, A, C, E creates the minor ninth. And we're doing that for each of those root notes. So it's D minor 9, F major 9. So these are different type of chords as well. They're not all minor 9 chords. This is A minor 9, and this is C major 9. And at the end, I broke up the chord into two different pieces just to lead into the beginning chord. It's very simple. Now, the key here is to also be in a lower octave, because if we raise this up an octave, it doesn't have that same jazzy sound. Sounds more cinematic than jazzy. So you also want to make sure you're in those lower octaves for the jazzy tone. Okay, to get that classic jazzy tone. Now the next chord progression, all we did to spice it up was add an extra bass layer. So these are very simple techniques. It sounds good, but it's not overly complicated. Another aspect of Drake beats is that they're not overly complicated because he's the star, not the beat. Okay, so we have here, if you take notice of the root notes for the chords, all we did was duplicate those and pull them down an octave. So now they have an extra bass layer. And this adds boom. This adds a little more attitude to the story. So if you want to kind of make the chord progression evolve without having to change it up with so many chords, you can just add bass layers to add more attitude. So these are just a couple tricks you can use in your chord progressions. I'll let you hear pattern 1 to 2 and hear the difference between the chords. So listen out for that bass tone in the second half. That's how you can change it up without overly doing it. So these are just small techniques you can use. Again, the focus here is ninth chords and also including that bass octave for an evolution in the chord progression. So that is the most important part to this specific song. So thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com. If you want to learn more about music theory, go to BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory. Thanks for watching. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.